In this video, we will show you the basic components of the event management feature. The event management gives us an indication of the system and the CMDB status and events. The features we will see include the dashboard, how to add a manual connection, how to create a technical service, how to create an alert group, and the alert console and alert timeline. We're logged in with a user who has the event management admin role. First, we navigate to the dashboard to see the business services and their alerts. We see here all the different business services color-coded to show their status as chosen in the application navigator above. Business services on the dashboard have different sizes depending on their priority. Business services can be created in multiple ways. There are discovered business services, which are discovered automatically, technical business services that are user-defined collections of CIs, and manually created business services that are created by connecting existing CIs in the CMDB. Let's see how to create a manual business service. First, navigate to Manual Services. Click New and enter a name for your business service. In this case, Demo Service. Then, we change the operational state to Operational. And to save the business service, we right-click and choose Save. Now, we add a CI to the business service. Under Related Links, click New and then choose the CI you want to add. In our case, we add a CI with this IP. Clicking View Map will open the map for the manual business service we've just created. Of course, it can also be viewed in the dashboard. The next feature we will talk about is creating a technical business service. In the Technical Services page, the user can create a common list of CIs by filtering the CMDB according to specific criteria. Click New to create a technical service. First, enter a name. In our case, we want to group all the Windows operating system machines as one technical service. We add the appropriate filter and then click Update and View Results. After updating the query, the technical service will display all the Windows machines in the CMDB. Of course, this technical business service can also be viewed in the dashboard. Similarly, alerts can also be grouped together. We will create a new group including all alerts whose severity is major. We fill in a name for the group. We create the required filter, and we save the group by clicking Update. We can view the group in the dashboard as well. The alerts are displayed in the dashboard in a regular list view. When clicking a specific business service, only its alerts will be shown. Another option to view the alerts is in the Alerts page. It gives us information regarding all alerts in the system and lets us access all the functionality related to alerts. By clicking on the alert, all the alert properties are shown along with various options to handle the alert. You can open or close the alert according to its state. You can bind an incident to an alert by clicking the Create Incident button. The incident will include the alert information in it. You can add some content to the incident. Alerts can also be bound to an incident by choosing one from the existing events. If the user doesn't want to take any action, the Acknowledge button can be pressed and the alert will be marked as acknowledged. There are several options to view the alerts. The overview page displays different graphs, each one showing different statistics in the system. The Alert Timeline page shows us the alert history. For more information, please consult our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.